Hello everyone, this Thierry Sicard tutorial number 8 start the part number 2 of the electromagnetism dedicated to the transformer. We will review the main transformer equations, the transformer used as an adaptation impedance, and the analysis of a transformer with a resistive load, and finally the transformer driven by a current source. If we start with a single coil with U voltage and I current, we will have U equal N d phi over dt and Ni over reluctance equal phi. Now, if we add a second coil, noted secondary coil, with Us and Is, we need to change U and I by Up and Ip and Np for the primary coil. The power Up times Ip on the primary side goes through the magnetic flux to the secondary power Us times Is, with Us equal Ns times d phi over dt. Of course, phi equal Np times Ip over reluctance. But as the magnetic flux is common with both coils, phi is also equal to Ns times Is over reluctance. From this relation, we get NpIp equal NsIs, which gives the current relation Is equal Ip over N if we set N as Ns over Np. The flux variation versus time d phi over dt on the primary coil is equal to Up over Np. But of course, as each coil sees the same magnetic flux variation, d phi over dt is also equal to Us over Ns. From this relation, we get Up Ns equal Us Np, which gives the voltage relation Us equal Np. So, Us and Is can be replaced respectively by Np and Ip over N. The transformer ratio is N, which is given by Ns over Np, respectively the secondary and primary number of turns. The R power on secondary side is R times Is square. As Is equal Ip over N, we can write the power resistance function of the primary current by replacing Is by Ip over N. So we will get the same power if we connect the resistance R over N square directly on the primary side. Both red rectangles show that both resistances have the same power. In other way, resistance R on the secondary side is viewed as R over N square from the primary side. For the capacitor, Cp view from primary side is N square times Cs. Of course, R is divided by N square and C is multiplied by N square, which means Rc value does not change because Rc is a time. For the inductor Lfp, view from primary side is equal to Lfs divided by N square. Of course, R and L are both divided by N square, which means L over R value does not change because L over R is equivalent to time. Impedance adaptation is one of the key functions of the transformer, especially before the solid-state electronic. Indeed, at the time of vacuum tube, the tube had high voltage, but not too much current capability. So, to drive the low impedance of the loudspeaker, a transformer was attached to a loudspeaker. The transformer was reducing voltage and increasing current. In this example, a 8-ohm loudspeaker impedance could be viewed from the tube as a 3.2 kilo-ohm load. In this animation, the target is to show the current inside the transformer coils with and without a resistive load on the transformer secondary. At the beginning, the secondary is open, so IS equals 0. As soon as we apply a constant voltage source on the primary side, the primary coil will force a linear magnetic flux versus time in the magnetic circuit. As IS equals 0, the primary current will be also linear with the formula dIP over dt equals UP over LP. At T equals TR, we connect a resistor on the secondary of the transformer. Of course, as the secondary voltage is US, the current in the secondary will be IS equals US over R. But inside the transformer, the sum of all currents cannot be changed because the UP voltage forces the linear flux variation. So the secondary current, NS times IS, must be cancelled by the same amount of current in the opposite way, NP times IPR, noted IPR because it is a primary current but linked with the resistor R. On the primary side, the current will be the sum of the current in the primary inductance LP plus the current which supplies the resistance on the secondary. If we replace the secondary resistance by the resistance viewed from the primary side, RP equals R over N square, we can do a new schematic with everything on the primary side. The resistor will have IPR and IPM in the inductor LP. Or we keep the primary and secondary with the secondary voltage equal to N times UP, providing IS in the resistor R. But the primary current will be the sum of LP current plus the current of the resistor R on the primary side. But in this case, the primary current is IPM plus IPR. When the primary side is driven by a current source, the secondary can be shorted because the current is controlled. If the transformer is driven by a current source, the secondary will provide an equivalent of the current source. In this case, the magnetic flux is almost only between both coils, see blue area. The magnetizing current sum of NPIP plus NSIS has a phase of 90 degrees to provide the opposite phase between NPIP and NSIS. I want to thank you for your attention. On my next TRC car tutorial number 9, we will talk about the transformer invention history, the first demonstration of high voltage line to be able to transport electricity on long distance, and we will show how to do a physical space model of the transformer with electric and magnetic model. See you soon and stay tuned.